Everybody will want to know how to do this if you haven't done it before. So you want to take a chocolate chip of yellow oxide. And what brush are you using? This one?
Uh-huh.
Okay. And you want to take a little bit, not much at all, doesn't take much, of black. And what we're going to do is mix them. Where is the... do we have the golden matte medium?
Oh, it's on that table back there.
It's in a big bottle. Oh, there it is. Okay, I'll need some of that too. So, you want to make it a little bit juicy. Grab a little bit of this. It's going to come out sort of a green looking. Who would have thought black and yellow make green, but it does. You don't want to get it too dark, and you don't want to get it too pale. Where's the icon? Right here. See, it's somewhere around. Also, with the acrylic paints, you'll notice they always dry slightly darker than they are when they're wet. So, I use this. You can use Magic Mix for this. There's some probably that in bottles that you can just take a couple.
You do?
Yeah. Well, that's more than plenty.
What is Magic Mix?
It's the same thing about, it's almost the same thing as this.
Okay.
Yeah.
And it does what?
Oh, when paint is basically pigment, which is ground up stones. You know, pigment.
Right.
It's powder. It's mixed with a medium, and in this case, acrylic medium. But you can dilute it so much. But if you keep diluting it, it's not going to stick. You know what I mean? And this is more medium that gives it the binder that the paint needs to stick. That way, when you add this and water, you can make it very transparent. That's the whole point. That's what we're doing.
Thank you.
Now, this part, so you can see how transparent and light it is. I usually try to work in sections on the face, like I might do the forehead first. You see, it doesn't look like I'm doing much. It's not like you're painting a wall in a house. You know, you're not trying to do it in one stroke. It's going to take maybe 10 coats of transparent. If you try to do it heavy, it'll look very uneven. But if you do it with a lighter hand, like this, transparently, you'll have more success. Because the object is to get it done without any brush strokes. You don't want to see brush strokes. So that's why you want to change the direction of your brush when you're doing it. You don't want to overload your brush, because then you push around in these puddles of paint, you know? You just want it to make it look as even as possible. And you'll do this many, many times. And eventually, after you get two or three coats on, like this transparently, see how I did that? I tapped it off with my hand to soften it and blend it so there wasn't any brush strokes visible. After you get a few transparent layers on, you can use more pigment. gradually add more pigment as you need it. But if you start out with too much pigment, you're not going to have much success. These first coats have to be very transparent. That has to dry completely.
Is this the same thing, matte medium?
Yep.
Okay.
Might not be the same quality, but it's the same thing. I know this is good.
No.
I know this will seal against the pencil ones.
No, I understand.
But I don't know that that works.
I found that. I couldn't.
Yeah, yeah. It is the same thing.
Yet.
And some of these, this one dries really flat. Some of them get a little bumpy. I don't like that. I like it nice and flat.
Yeah. What's the mix that you use there, please, because I missed it?
Oh, I was just using gold oxide with a tiny bit of black and water and some
medium.
This is where you need the medium. And they don't need much, just a few drops. And that'll keep your paint from rubbing off or coming off.
Okay.
But you can't paint over wet paint. This is, if you tilt it at the light, you see, still wet. You can tell. You can tell it's wet. When it's dry, it's pretty flat. And when it's dry, you just do it again, and again, and again, and again. And then at one point, you'll stop and you'll say, "Ooh, it looks a little bit uneven." So you'll take some more very diluted, nearly dry brush, and just do it where the light spots are. Every now and then you're going to do that. And then go back and do a whole wash over the thing. Until it gets to an intensity like that. You can barely see the gesso through it. You know, it is slightly transparent. It takes a while. All right. Everybody got it?
Yes.
Thank you.
And when I look at this, you were talking about movement. Like, I see movement.
Yep.
Of the paintbrush, but you're saying to not do that?
Huh?
You're saying to not do that?
No. You will see some movement, but it won't be too drastic.
Okay.
The face, you want it to be very flat when it starts. Because when we start putting the light on, that pulls out the dimension on it. Yeah, it's going to look very flat.
Okay, thank you.
Just watch.
I'm just putting on my light washes.
Is that the second one?
That is the second one. You see, I have a hole there. You know what happened?
Mm-hmm.
Drop of water fell on it.
Oh, okay.
So it made a hole. But that's no problem at all.
You wait for it to dry? Is that
I
it?
Don't have to wait.
Dryer.
I don't know how you work at home.
So for the Holy Family, it will be the same for all faces, right?
I think so.
Okay.
I don't see any reason to have them different.
Mm-hmm.
Different sand cure. I mean, you could if you want to.
No.
Sand cure could be any color to brown, honey brown, to greens, and even go into a little bit of turquoise even. I have seen icons with turquoise sand cure. It's pretty effective, but it's unusual for sure.
So how do you fix that hole?
How many what?
How do you fix that hole?
Oh, I'll just let it dry,
and then,
you know. I ain't too worried about it. It's going to have a lot of paint on it at the end anyway, so. What hole?
No, it's gone.
It's gone. Okay.